to all soccer lovers across the world, especially in Africa, Europe, where the game is, of course, has a lot of fans. We will not forget that day in a hurry, December 17th, Thursday last week to be precise, when Chelsea Football Club announced that it has parted ways with the chief coach of the club, Jose Mourinho, because the club could no longer continue with the season of that particular theme. And of course, a lot of us have already thought that was going to happen at a particular stage in the season. So many bad results coming Chelsea. We're losing 9 games out of 16. Wasn't really good enough, but a lot of accolades, a lot of love, a lot of messages has been sent out to the coach himself, Jose Mourinho. 23 trophies, incredible in 15 years career as a coach. That is really awesome for the special one. I also paid special tribute to Jose on my Facebook page, on my Twitter page on that Thursday. It was a double celebration for him because the players also responded positively in this direction, because on Saturday when they took on Sunderland of Football Club with Sam Allardyce, of course, in charge, they scored 2 goals in less than 15 minutes of that game, and of course winning that game by 3-1. A lot of statements causing some players, mentioning some players in particular, especially Eden Hazard, Cesc Fabregas and Diego Costa, calling them 3 rats. A lot of posters, banners being raised at Stamford Bridge on that day. And on the other side, in Old Trafford, in Manchester, the United fans also were chanting Jose Mourinho as they were being beaten by Norwich City by 2-1 that day, saying they no longer want Louis van Gaal to be their coach. So what do you think will happen? Do you think Jose Mourinho will be the coach of Manchester United? It is football, so impossibility is nothing and does not exist. Jose might just be the next coach of England. Jose Mourinho himself came out on Sunday night saying, releasing a statement through his lawyers in the United States, in Los Angeles to be precise, that he would like to remain in the UK, and of course he's ready to take on a managerial role as soon as possible, and that he's not going to attend any top flight games so as not to raise hope of any team or give any unnecessary rumor, but you'll be seeing him at game venues, but they will not be top games are to be seen, and he would like to be respected and given his privacy, and I think he also deserved that. A lot of people were already thinking Jose will also take sabbatical as Pep Guardiola and Carlo Ancelotti has done in the past, but he says football is in his DNA. He is ready to go back to administration as soon as possible. But you know what the platform is all about? It is Limitless Soccer. And my name is Bayonle Arashi. The love a lot of us have for Jose will not go away easily. And we will always follow and watch his career as he progresses in the beautiful game. Quickly, last weekend, there were lots of results across Europe. In Italy, Inter were beaten, the leader of the Italian Serie A were beaten by Lazio yesterday by 2-1, and of course with 2 red cards in that particular game as well. So they've not lost their place just yet, but of course they lost that particular game. Juventus won by 3-2 against Capi away from home. They won that particular game. Mario Mandzukic scoring 2 in that particular one. In France, Paris Saint-Germain are still in charge. They defeated Caen by 3-0. Zlatan Ibrahimovic cannot stop scoring for that team. Watford, of course, defeated Liverpool in the English Premier League by 3-0, giving Jurgen Klopp another defeat by Liverpool. I'm sure Jurgen himself will have been thinking English Premier League is not like the German Bundesliga. It's a different scenario in England. Other results that came our way over the weekend: Tottenham Hotspur defeated Southampton by 2-0. Crystal Palace, they are really, really, really in the mood. They defeated Stoke City by 2-1. What about Real Madrid? 10-2. They defeated their opponent that day. Gareth Bale, Cristiano Ronaldo, Benzema, all scoring for fun on Saturday in that particular... Was it a Saturday? I think it was on Sunday they played that particular game. But today, basically, do you think... I want to talk about Jose Mourinho. Do you fans think Jose might be coaching Manchester United. Do you think it is possible that Jose, with all the love, he has shown the love to Chelsea publicly at every avenue, even while as Real Madrid coach, saying there's a club he knows will never give up on him, and that is Chelsea. Do you think him taking this decision to public coach Manchester United, you know, it's going to come in the form of rumor, and as time goes on, the rumor might be really, really realistic. So he might just be coaching Manchester United come January, because any game, any loss for Luis Van Gaal again might just be shown the exit at the Theater of Dreams. Also in the Italian Serie A, AC Milan won 4-2 against Frosinone. Yeah, that's the name of the team. They won by 4-2. And I did not mention the name of the team Real Madrid defeated earlier. It was Rayo Vallecano. 10-2. And they came out earlier today saying that they are really embarrassed by that game. One of the biggest games in English Premier League will come up later today in about 2 hours from now. That will be between Arsenal Football Club and Manchester City. Well, I could have given you the result, but this particular vlog is being done before that game. So, but come midweek, I will definitely come talk about that, because that will be one of the biggest highlights of this week. So, I will do probably a special on that particular game on Wednesday or Thursday. So, watch out for that. Chelsea defeated Sunderland by 3-1. And congratulations to Barcelona Football Club winning the World Club Cup for the third time in a row early Saturday morning by beating the Argentine team River Plate 3-0. The son of the soil, Lionel Messi, scored in that particular game. And Luis Suarez, I think he's the best striker, he's the most hardworking and the best striker in the world right now, winning that particular tournament in Japan. So congratulations once again to FC Barcelona. They will be back in Spain later this week to continue in the Spanish La Liga. And of course, Atletico Madrid were beaten yesterday. Yes, they were beaten by 1-0. That goal coming up in the very, very, very last minute of that particular game. And a Nigerian scored for Roma, Sadiq Umar, scoring the second goal for Roma against Genoa yesterday in the Italian Serie A. The young striker standing at 6'7", scoring with a header in the last minute of that particular game. This is about the little information I'm able to bring your way again today on Limitless Soccer. And my name is Bayonle Arashi. Let's get the discussion going. Follow me on my social media platform. On my Facebook, I'm Bayonle Arashi. Send me a friend request. Follow me on Twitter, on Facebook, at Midas Soccer. On Instagram, I am at Midas Soccer. You could see all the past episodes of this vlog on my YouTube page at www.youtube.com/Bayonle Arashi. To the special one, again, we wish you the best on this platform, and your lovers across the world, I'm sure, will continue to follow your success as a coach, because we believe you are a winner anytime, any day, and anywhere. It's Limitless Soccer till I come your way again midweek. God bless you all. Remember, as I always say, believe in yourself and stay awesome. God bless you. I love you guys. Bye for now.